the show, I think not. Welcome, Pearl Jam!
Thank you.
welcome now from Pearl Jam, Eddie Vedder and Mike McCready. Mike, hey, Bill. Eddie, lovely to see you. Now, you sure that's the right way around? Has one of those got something in it?
Both of them have something in it.
It appears to be tea.
Yeah.
Just checking. Now, you've just done a huge, lovely show in London. People went mad for tickets. There were thousands of people who couldn't get in. You haven't really been on tour for a long time, have you? It's not like you've been...
We went to Canada and Latin America while we were making this record, kind of, to stay on our toes. But we just haven't been to Europe in 5 or 6 years.
We're very pleased to see you, aren't we?
Oh, yeah!
I suspect this man here, just come forward a moment. I think, it might be a plant, because now this is very good. That's not a plant, that's a pear. Thank you very much. Stand back. There is a pear here. Mm-hmm.
It's not a pear, actually.
Isn't it?
It's an avocado.
Avocado pear. Yeah. Is that a fruit?
Or English pear. Is that English
An avocado
fruit?
Pear.
Could be English pear.
But is that a fruit or a vegetable?
I don't care.
Correct answer. Now, you were very much part of the Seattle thing, the grunge thing. You moved there. Do you all still live there? Is that your base?
We're all still around Seattle, and except for one of our bass players in Montana. But we always get together and rehearse and record in Seattle, so we're there.
Does that have a great vibration to it, that place, city?
Yeah, it's a pretty great, beautiful city. It will have a little bit of rain, much like you do over here. I love it. It's got a great vibe to it, and it's got a good music scene.
Yeah. And who were the people that who were the first people that you sort of influenced you, and the sort of people you were kind of wanted to sound like?
Well, I guess first was Motown for me, but then it quickly got into British music, and especially The Who was the one that stood out for me. And I think that we're kind of carrying on. I think every band wants to invent things and play things that no one's ever played before. But I think in some ways we're also processing the stuff that we grew up listening to, and hopefully we can do it in an original way and still be like proud purveyors of the art form, kind of rock and roll.
So it is rock and roll what you're playing. Sounds great. Now, we've got actually, lovely, if you could care to walk down memory lane with us, we've got, I think, maybe the last time we're in the BBC, perhaps, and I'm going to show it to you. Stand back, it's exciting. Looking back, I know it's always difficult to look at yourself early on.
Because you have so much more dignity now. Yeah.
Well, that's right. No, you kind of think that I don't know what it is, but it is hard looking back at yourself. But looking back at that, how do you feel that you've changed?
I think my hair changed.
Yeah.
I don't know. We're just way more comfortable now.
It's too bad that kind of wisdom and intellect don't always match up with youth,
Yeah. Isn't that a shame?
It's sometimes, youth is kind of wasted on the young,
I guess.
That's
right.
but we still, music has kept us feeling young. But I feel like, I feel like we're a better band now than we ever have been. And we've worked hard to stay together to allow ourselves to progress as a band and try to make better records than we ever had, so.
And I think here is the evidence that I have.
It's our last attempt, anyway.
Well, you're right. Youth is wasted on young, wealth is wasted on the old, but we're all here. And will you play that song again for us at the end of the show?
If you ask one more time nicely.
Please.
Later. Okay, no.
Thank you very much indeed. Eddie and Mike from the brilliant Pearl Jam. Let's finish where we started with the one and only Pearl Jam. Thank you.
your song.